The MacBricks webcast is focused on bringing distinguished Indians and others from diverse fields of science, medicine, technology, and philosophy to learn from each other and to create a new understandings and foster new ideas related to healthcare.
Hey, good evening, guys. Good evening. This is Ramana Namaraju, host of the MedBricks webcast. Today is a, you know, I decided to do once a week or twice, maybe once a week or once in 2 weeks. I like to do a cultural show because India is a spiritual home for the entire Eastern philosophy. So philosophy is the central cornerstone of all the science and technology. So I wanted to, you know, yesterday, a couple of days ago, I presented Ramanujan. That is how much influence he has on the culture on him. So that is important. Cultural things are extremely important in this one. So I am doing something culturally, trying to do cultural program once a week at maybe 30 minutes. So it is something that how somebody thinks different way. For example, I'll give an example is that in a quantum physics, one of the concepts is electron could be in multiple states, multiple places, space, multiple locations. That's basically New York, say that New York and Los Angeles. So it is a important, so that to understand that, for Western minds is a very conflicting. For me, it's extremely easy. In Mahabharata, Lord Krishna is in two places at the same time. He has Lord Krishna has 8 wives and 16,000 girlfriends, Gopikas they call. So he's not only intellectually smart, but he's also a playboy a little bit, Lord Krishna. You know, so he did a, he was very influential in the process. So I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about the so I understood the science. I understood the culture. I understood the concept of scientific concept where things can be in multiple places, quantum entanglement or anything, is easy to understood through the for me through the Indian mythology. So it became easy. I actually explored philosophy or Indian mythology through science rather than other way around. So it was much easier for people to accept the quantum physics concepts, in fact, in Indian culture, because it's very close to a lot of Buddhism, Hinduism, and all those cultures. So that's why I did that. Okay. So what I'm doing is, this is a state of Orissa I'm talking about today, a special state of Orissa. Let me show you the what I'm talking about. And, one second, give me. Yeah. So let me talk about this Orissa thing. This is a Konarka temple that's called Sun Temple. Exactly, it is orchestrated and architecture was, the Carl Sagan went to Konarka Temple, Sun Temple. Carl, before he, in his Cosmos program, he did in Konarka Temple in the Cosmos. So one of the things that how they measured the age of the universe. Konarka Temple gave a big history of it. It is not that far from original our scientific calculations. It was an amazing. That's what he said. Even Carl Sagan said that. So it is an amazing concept. So I'm going to scientifically and then our culture, Indian culture. There's a lot of food. And tradition, clothes, and the temples, and the dances, there's a lot of those things there. There are two guests that are supposed to join, and they're having a hard time joining. I don't know why, but the one is Melissa Singh, and she's a Odisha dancer. She was very well known in the area. But I'm going to show you the Odisha background and culture to you in a second. I'll take there and show you. But the most important is that these cultures is a two. This is started 200 years BC. This dance culture started in the. I think the epicenter of the culture of India is in Odisha, in my view. It is where it started. That's why I started a program with Odisha. Odisha is a state. They used to call it Odisha. The English people changed the names, and then after independence, we changed it back. You know, that's what has happened, you know. So let me, this is the, that is the left side, Puri Jagannatha Temple. That's also very famous. So, but these, a lot of visitors go there. That is very, you know, these two are tourist places. And let me play some. I have a friend whose name is Reena Pathak and Mahesh Pakala. They took me to, we went to a show in Palo Alto Stadium. There's a children's home, Adruta Home. It's called Adruta Home. These are all orphan children. They don't have parents or anybody. They left on the streets, whatever the reasons are. What they did was he took them under their wings, and then they call Adruta Home. Adruta is an orphan home in Odisha, state of Odisha, and located in Bhubaneswar. They came, they visited the United States and they around the world. They are an amazing dancers. There is just very impressive dancing they did. Okay. So let me show you some. I will show you that. Odissi dancing, you know, that it is very. I'm going to show you. So one second. But it is a very interesting how this whole thing is. So you can call Reena Pathak if you want to help this children of orphan children who really studied the Odisha dance. So Melissa Singh is from the United States. She's from Atlanta. She moved to India, and then she spent almost 10 years learning this dance. Okay. So Reena Pathak is from Bhubaneswar. She is a representative. She is a TV personality. So she is also very much involved with the state of Odisha's culture. Odisha, during the independence time, we do a big show in Silicon Valley. In the show that they do is the floats. Odisha floats. The floats are one of the best ones. Okay. So let me show you this video a little bit, and then see if we can play that video.
Oh,
That is a beautiful dance. I went to Silicon Valley to, I was in the Palo Alto. I went to this program. It was an amazing. I met a lot of scientists. You know, my favorite scientist, Leonard Susskind, he was there. He's one of the famous scientists, physicists. He's a god. So I met him there and his wife. It's an amazing experience. And then this this was one of the very influential culture in India, Odissi dances. So let me show you some of the Odissi culture. I'm in the home of a Odissi dancer, Melissa Singh. So let me show you a little bit of that background for you, all of you. Okay, hold on 1 second. I'm going to take it there and then show you a little bit of that, just to be patient 1 second. Hey, Melissa, how are you? She's, I'm in the home of Melissa Singh, a Sproul. She's from... sorry about that. And this is, she spent 10 years learning the Odissi dance. It is an amazing experience. I tell you, I was so impressed. In the Kuchipudi, we have southern India several dances, but Odissi dance is on the top of it in my view. So thank you so much. And then I want to show you, Melissa, can you come down and a little bit of explain your background and a little bit of your association with the Odissi dance.
Namaste, I'm Melissa Sproul Singh. And I have come from a background of modern dance in the USA when I was a teenager. And then I got exposed to Odissi dance by way of Naropa Institute in Boulder, Colorado. My guru came there and was teaching for 3 summers. And so I got to study with him, and then I followed him to India and studied full-time for the next 6 years in a row when I had an Indian Council for Cultural Relations scholarship. And I studied along with several other foreign students and a lot of Indian students. And we put on quite a few performances and did a little bit of touring. And then I tried to bring the culture back here to America. I opened a Ganesh Academy of Indian Arts in 1985 and have hosted my teachers visiting from India several times now. And they come and they put on workshops and performances. And I'd like to bring them again, speaking in particular of Guru Surendranath Jaina, the late Guruji, and his daughter, Pratibha Jaina Singh, and her daughter, Rodri Singh. And you're welcome to watch all of these on YouTube if you look up their particular names. And we have a 10-minute video I wanted to show you, which tells all about the Odisha culture. But Ramanaji says too long.
Yeah. I'm going to show you quick a little bit, okay? So let me, before I show you the video, let me show you the she collected from the drums. What do you call?
Pakawach.
I don't know. You know, she collected a lot of Hindu cultural odishi from odishi dance music related to drums and all those things. And she just finished the entire thing is a very odishi influence. You know, so you can see that the drums and here the drums are, you see that, drums and everything. It's an amazing that how this culture works. So, in recent studies by Harvard, they said that, by doing the, by watching or even neural node, I forgot that name, but watching the dance itself, it reduced the progression of or dancing, practicing dancing, reduces the progression of the Alzheimer's, it increases the cognitive powers. So Harvard has a study on the dances itself. And I think you all, we all, music and dance is a very fundamental, our brains, our human brains are evolved into adopting these kind of things. So we cannot be isolated from all the cultures. I think we need to accept and expand our horizon about all the cultures of the world. This is the Orissa culture, is one of the oldest. It's too busy. I'm going to show you a quick video and let me share the screen with you guys. Then after that, I'm going to show you a quick video on the culture. And if you need the Adruta home representative, I'm trying to connect with the I hope you can see my screen. This is narrated by Melissa Singh.
The exuberant spirit of life fully blossomed in India's exquisite arts. In the Natya Shastra, the sacred Hindu text dating back to 200 BC, the sage Bhata Muni consolidated and codified various traditions in dance, drama, and music. India's classical dance leads us into a world of myth and devotion, rooted in ancient rituals, stories of the deities, and seasonal festivals. Among the eight classical dance styles, there are only two that have their origin in the Natya Shastra. Bharatanatyam originated in South India in Tamil Nadu, Odissi originated in the eastern coastal state of Orissa and is considered the oldest of the classical dance styles. In ancient times, Odissi was performed in the temples by the Devadasi, or temple dancers. The dance not only has its roots in being performed for the deities, but also is performed to transform the audience spiritually as well. Lord Jagannath, who is a form of Krishna and a symbol of universal love, is worshipped throughout Orissa. His statue is ever present at Odissi performances. It is to Lord Jagannath that an invocation is made at the beginning of each performance. The grace and energy of Odissi wraps the viewer in this sense of love, joy, and devotion. Over the last 2,000 years, three schools of Odissi developed, the Mahari, the Nartaki, and the Gotipua. Odissi was originally performed as a daily temple ritual by a group of women, or Maharis, who performed this art as part of the daily temple ritual service for Lord Jagannath in his temple in Puri. Dances performed by these women were purely devotional and ritualistic by nature. With the invasion of the Mughals came the dancers for the royal courts, known as Nartaki. In the 16th century, the Gotipua tradition, in which young boys were dressed as girls, emerged as entertainment for the public. When the morality of the Nartaki and the Mahari came under attack during British rule, only the Gotipua dance survived. In modern times, after India's independence, Odissi was reconstructed. And by 1958, Odissi had regained its full status as a classical Indian dance. Today, it is widely appreciated throughout India and is performed all over the world. The modern Odissi reclaimed the ancient Mahari's emphasis on dramatic expression and spiritual devotion and integrated the medieval Gotipua tradition, emphasizing the more physical aspects of the dance. There are a number of features particular to Odissi: the bhangis, or positions of the body, padavedas, or positions of the feet, and mudras, or hand gestures. One of the most prominent characteristics of Odissi is the tribhangi. The concept of tribhangi divides the body into three parts: head, torso, and hips. This pose gives a sensual, graceful form that is unlike any other classical style. The rasas, or emotions, are portrayed using facial expressions as well as body postures. Mudras, or hand positions, are used in abhinaya, or storytelling. The themes of Odissi are almost exclusively religious in nature. They most commonly revolve around Lord Krishna. One form of Odissi dance being carried down from the last generation of masters is that of the late Guru Surendranath Jaina. Guru Jaina's style is devotional, meditative, and deeply expressive of the culture from which it came. He evolved his dynamic style by recreating the dance from his interpretation of the similarities between images seen in Orissa's rural culture in everyday life and Orissa's various arts: Jatra theater, Patachitra scrolls, Talapatra paintings, Uriya texts, and the exquisite temple sculptures of the Lingaraj, Jagannath Puri, Konark, and Chonsat Yogini Temple. The most unique element of Guruji style is the way it is entrenched in Bhakti Ras. Bhav, emotion, is given prime importance in all his dances. Hence, his dance is meant for Atmaranjan, pleasing the soul, rather than Lokranjan, pleasing the world. Guruji was of the opinion that every emotion, or ras, has its appropriate place in life. Therefore, his dances reverberate with both tandava, or masculine, and lasya, or feminine elements. In contrast to other Odissi styles which emphasize the lasya, his dance also is characterized by rapid changes in both taal, or rhythm, and style, echoing the many ups and downs of life. His style is so brilliant and deeply moving, it must be seen to be appreciated, and once seen can never be forgotten. In 2007, just months before he died, Guru Surendranath Jaina was presented the Sangeet Natak Academy Award by the President of India. This is one of the highest awards given for lifetime achievement in the arts. Pratibha Jaina Singh, Guru Jaina's eldest daughter, now carries on his work teaching at Trivini Kala Sangam in the same studio where Guruji taught for over 30 years. Throughout his lifelong journey, life and dance became intricately interwoven for Guru Jaina. He saw them not as two distinct identities, but instead mirroring each other in a myriad of ways. So inextricable were these for him that life itself was like the dance of creation, and dance the carrier of the essence of life.
Yeah, hello. That is narrated by Melissa itself. Melissa Singh narrated that beautiful video, really inspiring for all of us. The culture, even as an Indian, I don't know a lot of culture, that's what she's talking about is very interesting. The innovations require spread of knowledge, art, music, philosophy. Technology is not just only one you need to learn to innovation. Innovation comes from a different ideas, a combination of ideas. Human mind can accommodate and come up with the final solution for some of the problems we are facing. So I think the one of them is culture. We need to explore, we need to bring the culture to the front lines, to the part of the understanding, a wider understanding. Thank you for joining, Melissa. Thank you so much to join with us. Anything, final words you want to say? She is a dedicated dancer. Yeah, go ahead and see how much passionate you are.
This style of dancing gained my heart, and I devoted my life to continuing to study and went back to India many, many times. And at some point, I also married an Indian. And we were married for 9 years. Unfortunately, he's passed away. But I tried to carry this culture wherever I could, wherever I travel, and spread the love of Odissi dance as much as possible.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Melissa. Rina was trying to join. Rina Pathak and Mahesh Pakala, they're best friends from my Silicon Valley. And if you can support that, our number is right here. It's a children's home. Call Rina in 510-910-2823. Based in Silicon Valley, Rina is the one who is instrumental in bringing them to Silicon Valley. The Odissi orphan dance from the orphan home. So this is amazing. I really enjoyed very much that dance. And thank you. I'm going to close the program with the final dance, that Odissi dance that you want to see again. It's really an amazing. Let me show you. Thank you all for joining. Good evening. Bye.